Hello and welcome to another episode of the Thoughtfully Made Fiber Vlogcast. My name is Amy Scher and I am your host, as well as a knitting pattern designer, an owner of an online yarn shop. That part is new, still a little strange to say, but bear with me. I also sometimes spin and weave and sew. So I'm kind of a multi-crafter all maker here to share all about my going-ons. So last week I made an episode introducing my yarn shop, but in fact that was quite a tardy episode as the yarn shop had been open for 6 weeks already by the time the video came out. Thank you all so much to your warm response, your kind congratulations, and all the nice things you had to say about the yarn shop as well as your orders. I had such a good time reading all the comments and also packing all your orders. So thank you so much for that. So I know it feels like it's quite soon since the last video, but today I am here to share with you the product reveals, colorway reveals of our next collection, which is live today. By the time you see this, there's a good chance that the collection is either live or it's coming. And the date that it's coming is May 10th, Friday at 7 p.m. Central US time. So if you see anything you like in this collection, I highly recommend that you give the shop a look and maybe you'll find something to take home. Whether you are a new viewer or a returning viewer, thank you so much for being here. I appreciate you taking the time to spend a little time with me and look at these goodies together. So if you have a favorite item in this collection, please do leave a comment and tell us what it is. We'd love to know. And don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe if you want to see more of our shop updates and also just the things that I make in my day-to-day life. Without further ado, let's get into the yarn. If you didn't know already, May is Asian American and Pacific Islander Heritage Month, and kind of like a light theme, not like a hard theme, but just like a gentle, soft theme of this collection is just gathering all the AAPI makers that I know and admire, have worked with before, are new to me. The first dyer that I want to introduce to you to the shop for this collection is none other than someone you'll already be very familiar with. I think she is far more famous than I am. Her name is Amy from La Bien Amy, and she is also from this part of the country. Amy is currently based in Paris and has a line of beautiful yarns that we decided to bring to you today. So let me go ahead and go through some of my favorites. So how I select colors for my shop is quite haphazard. Sometimes there's a theme and sometimes it's just based on what I want in my own personal collection or yarns that I've long wanted myself. And this is certainly one of those. We'll be bringing in this base, which is the Merino Super Sock. It is, let's see, 465 yards of 75% superwash merino and 25% nylon. This is in the colorway Rose Quartz. You can really see like the stone inspired colorways. It really has that geological, naturalistic feeling to it. I would describe it as like a white and gray base with lots of speckles and browns, blues, pinks, even browns. The second colorway is one that I'll probably need to keep one for myself because it's just so beautiful. This is Winter Garden in the same Merino Super Sock base. All of these yarns will be in Merino Super Sock. This one is on a cream base with lots of speckles. Just all kinds of like every color of speckle you can imagine. There's some pink there, there's some brown there, and there's some green here, and blue right here. And I just love how chaotic and also gentle at the same time this color is. I think that'll knit up beautifully in socks. And now we kind of edge into the more colorful realm. Those are kind of like my two neutral-ish sock yarns. So it does feel like we constantly share about food-inspired things here, but here is another one. This colorway is called Girambap. I hope that I am pronouncing that correctly. I am not Korean. I did look up videos of Koreans saying it, so hopefully I pronounced it okay. Feel free to correct me in the comments always when it comes to a language that is not my own. Okay, Girambap. This is based on a delicious Korean dish. It is a breakfast dish, but also kind of like an anytime dish, if I understand correctly. Amy specifically wanted to dye this colorway for us because it is based on our, you know, I feel like it themes nicely with the AAPI Heritage Month. The dish is a bed of rice topped with egg and seaweed and condiments, sesame oil, sesame seeds. I see people put like soy sauce, butter, other things. It all mixes up into an easy meal. And this is the result of that inspiration. It has white and yellow bits for the eggs and rice, and beautiful seaweed colored little speckles. I love yellow in yarn, and actually I feel like I should knit more with yellow. So this is a great one to start with if you'd like to get into that yellow world. Here's another one I can't pronounce. I think it's the Magellanic Clouds, and it is a beautiful saturated and moody dark gray. I feel like the gray kind of leans a little bit purple to me. I feel like it is showing up nicely in this lighting, and it has purple and blue streaks and speckles throughout it. I think that's so pretty. I love this dark and moody color. I feel like it's like in a sock, this would knit up to be kind of the perfect neutral. It would look neutral until you kind of get up close to it, and then you're like, ooh, there's speckles. So this is another great one, the Magellanic Clouds. And now let's get into some brights. We have two semi-solid offerings for you. This one is called Sea Glass, and this one is called The Hotness. I love them both. One of my friends has already bought a Hotness, or The Hotness, and I love how like neon it is. You can see it here next to my much more subdued knitting for olive color on my body, and it's just so bright. Oh my gosh. I actually was thinking that because it's a very cloudy day, I'm not getting enough light and I'm using artificial light. And I was thinking actually that everything looks kind of muted, and I was like, something's wrong with my camera. But now that I'm looking at these, I'm like, oh, okay, no, it's me that's muted. It's me that's like a pasty gray color, and these colors show up correctly. That is so beautiful. I love a good bright, especially on socks, because it's not obtrusive. You can wear it with anything, because funky socks are fun and for everyone. So these are the six colors of La Bien Aimée Super Sock. These will all be coming in the collection on Friday. I'm so glad that I can bring these to the collection because I love sock yarn. I love La Bien Aimée. I've knit quite a few pairs using her yarn, and it can be kind of hard to get here in the United States. So it's another dyer that I wanted to bring to you here. Now we're gonna take a quick break from yarn and take a look at two pieces of notions that we have curated for you here in the shop. I've got here two notion tins made for us by Firefly Notes, who is a small maker based in Canada. These are handmade in Richmond, hand poured resin, small batch design. And this one is an empty one. It opens like this. This one is mine, so it's a little scratched up because I've already used it. But this one has beautiful cherry blossoms on it, which I think are so nice for late spring, early summer. I love this one. This one's empty. And then this one, the Kitty Kitty Knit Kit, comes with things inside of it. There's six cat-shaped stitch markers, one magnetic insert, and one tapestry needle inside. This is what the items inside look like. This one is for sale, so I'm not gonna take it apart. So those are two notions that we are offering this time around. I'm always in need of an extra notion tin or five in my life, so I decided to bring some into the shop. All right, so now let's get back into some more yarn. I met Rochelle of Moondrick Co. last year at Flock Fiber Festival. I so admired everything in her booth. I went around it so many times, touching every base. She really has an eye for interesting bases, so I wanted to bring one of her sock bases into our shop. So here is the first sock set. It is a BFL high twist sock set. I love BFL sock yarns because I find that merino, while it's soft, is wonderful, and I have many friends who can knit and wear them with no problems at all. But I really struggle with merino because I'm super hard on my socks. Now, I am never gonna yuck anyone's yum. Obviously, I am also carrying a merino-based sock. But personally, I do have a preference towards a BFL-based sock like this, just because I'm slightly monstrous on my socks and stomp around ruining them. This one is going to wear a little bit better for you, and it is a little bit more rustic feeling, a little bit more pokey, but I don't find that that's a problem on my sock once I knit it up. Merino does feel a little softer to me, but I wear BFL every day just fine. So this one is Teapot, which is a beautiful kind of like a teal green with speckles, pink speckles and neon green speckles. I love that part, look at that. I love that, the unexpected little pop of neon. And she's also dyed up a coordinating cerulean blue for us. And I have plenty of this in the shop. Hopefully you'll give it a try. And finally, I want to share the last colorway of sock yarn that's coming into the shop today. And it is a very, very special one. Rochelle, without being asked, dyed up this beautiful custom colorway for me. And I don't know how she knew. She just had like a sense of my aesthetic and the things that I like. I have named this sock set End of the Rainbow. It was dyed just for us. It's an exclusive custom color by Rochelle at Moondrake Co. And I called it End of the Rainbow because it's like every rainbow pastel color you can think of. Oh my goodness. And I don't see any speckles. To me, this is all just like beautiful hand-painted beauty. Everything is so pretty. It's like a perfect neutral, but with lots of pops of interesting colors. I love this so much. This game is definitely reserved for me. I'm taking this one home myself, and it comes with a beautiful orange rusty brown. Y'all know I love an orange rusty brown. I have so many samples knit up in this color, so I can't wait to dig into this particular set, and I hope that you enjoy it as well. So in my last video, I share the very first set of stitch markers that we made for our online yarn shop, and today I am back for the second one. So I have filled up my personal little tin here with my personal already stole from work stitch markers, and I'm going to show them to you. So these have been in heavy use already. The first one I want to show you is one that we made live last week. This is the Boba and Yarn Lovers stitch marker. He has lots of milk tea with bubbles and a pink ball of yarn. And this particular one comes with a recipe for my strawberry syrup, which is good for making strawberry milk tea, strawberry tea, as well as drizzling over ice creams, yogurts, all kinds of things. So that recipe originally came with my coffee subscriber only, and then it became kind of like a add-on to the effervescent pullover and the effervescent mini, and now it's also available with the Boba and Yarn Lovers stitch marker. And then I have a set of stitch markers. Oh my gosh, these are super cute. Matcha themed stitch markers. So we've got a matcha whisk. So anyone who's made matcha knows that a whisk is one of the best ways you can make your matcha in the traditional way. And then I have a spoonful of matcha. I feel like the matcha spoon is like an underrated, super important part of the matcha making process. So we just had to include it. And finally, the matcha latte. So as usual with all our stitch markers, they are very easy to open and close with a large clasp ring that fits large needles, as large as you want pretty much. And they are good to use for both knitting and crochet. And because we wanted this to feel like a party, we also have a keychain. Oh, that's the wrong side. We also have a keychain. Oh my gosh. Ah. That is the Matcha and Yarn Lovers keychain. This can go on your keys, on your purse, in your project bag, just somewhere where you want to adorn your life with a little boost of matcha and yarn. It's so cute. That little skein. I think Moon, our artist, has done a killing job with that cute little skein. Oh, look how cute it is. And that blue color is so pretty. So all of these will be part of the collection today. I have been using them a lot already myself, and I hope that you all enjoy them as much as I do. And finally, to celebrate Asian American and Pacific Islander Month, we have a beautiful postcard, an art print from artist Ira Colandrino, who is a knitter and crocheter and also an illustrator, who has made this beautiful postcard for us. She named it Kinship in her first drafts, and I think that's such a lovely name for this beautiful postcard. This postcard is free with purchase of $75 subtotal or above. It has these beautiful friends knitting together around the table, surrounded by their vegetable starts, because I also love the garden, and their house plants and beautiful wall hangings and yarn and notions. And I think they're knitting a little oolong tank here, and that's an effervescent pullover. How adorable are these details? It's been so fun to work with Ira and come up with this together and create the artwork that I really envision for this collection. As you all know, Amy Shermakes has always been about collaborating with other small makers and artists, farmers, fiber makers, everything. This collaboration, this postcard, feels truly special to us. All purchases starting today will receive this postcard free with $75 purchase while supplies last. Yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. I feel like I'm being very salesy, which I'm not used to. However, I truly love everything that we've brought into the shop for you today, and I hope that you will enjoy taking a look at all of these beautiful things. I will link to this collection below in the description box. If you have any questions or comments about any of these yarns or notions, please do drop them in the comments below. I'd love to answer them. We always aim to source ethically made and beautifully designed and beautifully curated and also useful things for you in the shop, and we hope that we have succeeded in doing so. As always, we also have our Taiwanese high mountain oolong teas, as well as gauge rulers and other goodies in the shop for you, ready for you to peruse. So thank you so much for watching this collection reveal. I hope you all have a beautiful May week, and I will talk to you very, very soon.